This is Thomas Edison. The year is 1878. You are listening to my new invention, the phonograph. I hope that someday cowboys everywhere will use this device to record their music.
Have you ever wondered what happened to all that great country music you used to listen to on record? Well, we still have it, right here on Vinyl Country. This week's program includes the Canadian Spotlight, the Local Pick, we'll play Stump Tom, there's trivia, we'll have another installment of Older Than Dirt, and of course, we'll play some great country music, the kind you only find on record. We're about ready to fire up the turntables, so stick around. Now we're going to start things off today with a lady that was born Wynette Pugh. And when she signed on with Epic Records in 1966, they decided that she needed a name change. Now, she wanted to keep the Wynette part, but that day that she showed up at Epic offices, she was wearing her blonde hair in pigtails. The producer at the time, Billy Sherrill, looked at her and thought that she looked quite a bit like Debbie Reynolds from that movie, Tammy and the Bachelor. So thus came to be, as you've already guessed, Tammy Wynette.
Sometimes it's hard to be a woman, giving all your love to just one man. You'll have bad times and he'll have good times, doing things that you don't understand. But if you love him, you'll forgive him, even though he's hard to understand. Him, 'cause after all, he's just a man.
Tammy Wynette, what a voice. Stand By Your Man. Released in 1968, sold over 6 million copies. Now coming up next is this week's Country Couple.
It's a lesson too late for the learning, made of sand, made of sand.
In the wake of an eye, in your hand.
Are you going away with no word of farewell? Will there be not a trace left behind?
I
the subway's rumbling underground, underground.
Are you going away with no word of farewell? Will there be not a trace left behind?
I could have loved you better, didn't mean to be unkind.
You know that was the last thing on my mind.
This I know, this I know.
The weeds have been steadily growing.
Please don't go, please don't go.
Are you going away with no word of farewell? Will there be not a trace left behind?
I could have loved you better, didn't mean to be unkind.
You know that was on the mind. Are you going away with no word of farewell? Will there be not a trace left behind?
I could have loved you better, didn't mean to be unkind.
You know that was the last thing on the mind. You know that was the last thing on the mind.
A picture that I carry,
one we made some time ago. When they ask who's in the picture with me, I say just someone I used to know, just someone I used to spend some time with, just a flame that's lost its glow.
But I don't tell them of the nights I cry without you.
I say just someone I used to know, just someone I used to run around with, just a friend from long ago.
I don't tell them how lost I am without you.
I say just someone I used to know. I say just someone I used to know.
Now there's a couple of great songs sang by a couple of great singers, Dolly Parton and Porter Wagoner, Just Someone I Used to Know, and before that, The Last Thing on My Mind. You're listening to Vinyl Country, and we'll return in just a few moments. Stay with us. Now at this time, we move into the Canadian Spotlight. And this week we feature one Ian Dawson Tyson, born September 25th, 1933, in a place called Victoria, BC.
Well, them old boys are down in Texas, chew Copenhagen, wash it all down with that cooler. Ain't a bit bashful about speaking their minds. They'll tell you what's theirs and
what's yours. There's Waylon and there's Willie, they own about half the state. Sing of her glory all in song. Talk about your lovers and your fighters, while the rainbow bull riders, the whole thing takes a halt, goes on. Ride with me, Jesus, help me pull this heavy load. Don't let her slip, don't let her slide. You answer all our questions further down this muddy road. Oh, cowboys cross the great divide.
Divide.
Well, up north it's Saddle Bronx and it's hockey and honky tonks. Old Wilf Carter, 78s.
He yodeled.
Done stuff like chores when it's 20 below. Well, they're the things boy hates. Too much damn wind, not enough whiskey, drives them old northern boys flat wild.
And he may go to hell, or even Vancouver, he'll always be Alberta's child.
Yes, he will. With me, Jesus, help me pull this heavy load. Don't let her slip, don't let her slide. You answer all our questions further down this muddy road. Oh, cowboys cross the great divide.
If I
in Jesus, up in the bullets, heavy load. Don't let her slip, don't let her slide. You answer all our questions further down this muddy road. Old cowboys cross the great divide.
Divide.
Now, Ian, as a young fella, wound up in a bit of a rodeo wreck and was in the hospital, and that's where he took up guitar and began songwriting. He moved out to Toronto in 1958, and he soon began performing with a lady by the name of Sylvia Fricker. As the folk era came to an end, the West was still calling Ian, and he and Sylvia moved back to Alberta in 1969. And that's when Ian got back to his country roots.
Carlos Zaragoza left his home in Casas Grandes when the moon was full. No money in his pocket, just a locket of his sister framed in gold. He headed for El Sueco, stole a rooster called Gallo de Cielo. Then he crossed the Rio Grande with that chicken nestled deep within his arm. Now Gallo de Cielo was a rooster born in heaven, so the legends say. His wings, they had been broken, he had one eye rolling crazy in his head. He'd fought 100 fights, and the legends say that one night near El Sueco, they fought Cielo 7 times, 7 times he left Brave Rooster's dead.
My Teresa, I'm thinking of you now in San Antonio. I have $27 and the locket of your picture framed in gold. And tonight I'll bet it all on the fighting spurs of Gallo de Cielo. Then I'll return to buy the land that we stole from father long ago.
outside of San Diego, in the onion fields of Paco Monteverde. The bride of San Diego lay sleeping on a fancy bed of silk. And they laughed when Zaragoza pulled the one-eyed De Cielo from beneath his coat. But they cried when Zaragoza walked away with a $1,000 bill.
Oh, my Teresa, I'm thinking of you now in Santa Barbara. I have $1,500 and the good luck of your picture framed in gold. And tonight I'll bet it all on the fighting spurs of Gallo De Cielo. And I'll return to buy the land that we stole from father long ago.
The moon has gone to hiding, and the lantern light spills shadows on the fighting sand. As the wicked black named Zorro faces De Cielo in the night. And Carlos Zaragoza fears the tiny crack that runs across his rooster's beak. And he fears that he has lost the 50,000 that is riding on the fight.
Oh, my Teresa, I'm thinking of you now in Santa Clara. All the money's on the table, I am holding to your good luck framed in gold. And everything we dreamed of is riding on the spurs of De Cielo.
I pray that I'll return to buy the land that we stole from father long ago. Then the signal it was given, and the cocks they rose together far above the sand. And Gallo De Cielo sunk a gaff into Zorro's shiny breast. They were separated quickly, and they rose and fought each other 37 times. And the legends say that everyone agreed De Cielo fought the best. Then the screams of Zaragoza filled the night outside the town of Santa Clara. As the beak of De Cielo lay broken like a shell within his hand. And they say that Zaragoza screamed a curse upon the bones of Pancho Villa. When Zorro rose up one last time and drove De Cielo to the sand.
Oh, my Teresa, I'm thinking of you now in San Francisco. There's no money in my pocket, I no longer have your picture framed in gold. I buried you last evening with the bones of my beloved De Cielo. And I'm not determined by the land that we have sold my father long ago.
In 1989, Ian was inducted into the Canadian Country Music Association's Hall of Fame. Great honor. Now, not only is Ian a singer-songwriter and a roper, he's also an author these days. He's written a book recently about something close to his heart, the Wild Mustangs. It's called La Primera. You might want to pick that up.
While I was out riding the graveyard shift midnight till dawn, the moon was as bright as a reading light for a letter from an old friend back home.
And he asked me, why do you ride for your money? Why do you rope for short pay? You ain't getting nowhere, you're losing your share. Boy, you must have gone crazy out there. He tells me last night I run on to Jenny. She's married, she has a good life. Oh, you sure missed the track when you never come back. She's the perfect professional's wife. And she asked me, why does he ride for his money? Why does he rope for short pay? He ain't getting nowhere, he's a losing his share. He must have gone crazy out there. Then they've never seen the northern lights, never seen the hawk on the wing, never seen spring hit the great divide. Oh, they never heard old Camp Cookie sing. The last of my letter, I tore off a stamp for Black Jim. When Billy rode up to relieve me, he just looked at my letter and he grinned. And then he said, why do they ride for the money? Why do they roll for short pay? They ain't getting nowhere, and they're losing their share. Hell, they all must be crazy out there. And they've never seen the northern lights, never seen the hawk on the wing, never seen spring hit the great divide. Hell, they never heard old Camp Cookie sing. Yodelay, oh, 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 oh.
That's this week's Canadian Spotlight with Ian Tyson. Have you ever noticed that CDs don't have a whole bunch of yodeling on them these days? Hey, hang tight. We're going to be right back with Vinyl Country.
Fingers. not knowing any better than to think I had a love that would be true. Why I should be taken out, tarred and feathered, to have let myself be taken in by you. From now on, all my friends are gonna be strangers. I'm all through ever trusting anyone. The only thing I can count on now is my finger. I was a fool believing in you. Now you are gone.
Merle Haggard and the Strangers, and all my friends are gonna be strangers. And now we head to the phone lines.
This week's local pick is a longtime Fort St. John resident and a high-profile figure in our local music community. We've got Neil Skoggs today on the program. Thanks for joining us, Neil.
Oh, thanks for having me.
Hey, Neil, we always start the program by asking, who is your favorite artist and how did you get started in the music business?
Favorite artist? Eagles and Beatles.
Really? The 50s stuff? That kind of surprises me. I always knew you as a country drummer. Tell us about your musical beginnings.
Well, I got started in the music business when I was 12 years old. And I answered an ad in the newspaper in Medicine Hat and was fortunate enough to be involved with the Medicine Hat Lions Club Boys Band. They were a marching band that practiced a couple times a week and marched around the schoolyard, and we hit all the high spots, like the Calgary Stampede Parade and the Klondike Days Parade.
Holy cow. So were you a drummer there?
Yes. I had one drum. It was very simple, a snare drum. I was actually the lead drummer in the Medicine Hat Lions Club Boys Band.
The world-famous Calgary Stampede, holy cow. So, the Rhythm Nights, am I going back far enough?
That's the first one, yeah. The Rhythm Nights with Lucy Sheck and Tom Gerges and Ron Sheck and Kiwi Bishop.
And was Kiwi the guy from the radio station, or... Oh, no, wait a minute, that was Len.
Len Novak was in that group, too, yeah.
Wow, that's going back a few years now. So how long did you guys have that group together?
About 5 years. We went to Edmonton and cut an LP.
Wow, the recording studio must have been fun.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that was very interesting. None of us had ever been in a recording studio before.
Yeah, so and the Rhythm Nights were a dance band. You guys didn't have a singer.
Yeah, it was totally instrumental. Because I sure didn't know how to sing, and I guess neither did the rest of them.
Okay, Neil, take us ahead now. What was next?
I moved over to with Brent Baziski and Lauren McKerney. Played with them. The band was called Holy Smoke.
Yes, and you guys were very well known, and I know that you played tons of weddings.
Yeah, it was quite popular.
So bring us up to the next band.
After Holy Smoke... Lauren McKerney left. He went to be famous.
That's when you guys got Lauren warmed up enough that he could move to Nashville then.
Yeah, it was our fault, I guess.
So, and I know that after that you had Dave McGowan joined your group. And then where did you go?
After that, I think I played with Peter Preeb and Kevin Clark. And
what did you call that band?
Homegrown.
Homegrown. Now, I haven't heard that name for a long time.
Yes. I think it was right after that. A famous local personality, Tom Cole. Do you know? Oh, yeah, of course.
Yeah, quite well, yeah.
We played for a while together, too.
You know, that was a really fun band. That was with Peter Preeb and Larry Boudreau played guitar. And Neil, I'm sure I've never been in a band where I laughed any more than that. Man, oh, man.
No lack of laughs there.
Man, that was just a ton of fun. So... Neil, after that, you started the now famous Colt 45.
Yeah, actually, we started with Randy Gee and Glenn Kirkpatrick and Arlene Charlton. We started with that group, and then Tom Garcia joined us.
Yes, and then I know that later on, Drid Elias came along.
Yeah, that was after Glenn left and Randy left, and there was just Tom and Drid Elias and myself then. And then that lasted for like 13 years.
13 years, that's like some kind of record for a weekend band, eh?
Yeah, well, Tom had lots of patience.
So, Neil, tell us what you're doing nowadays.
Well, right now, I've just been playing with Tom Garcia again and Clint Giesbrecht and Kent Lessing. Yeah, we've just been doing fundraisers at the Royal Canadian Legion.
Yes, and I've actually been and heard you guys play there. You sound fabulous.
Yeah, well, thank you very much. Yeah, I just was able to attend one. There has been two, and I'm sure there'll be more.
And they're a great time, too. So, Neil, thank you very much for stopping by. Really appreciate it, and the best of luck to you.
My pleasure.
Well, folks, that concludes the Local Pick with this week's special guest, Neil Skoggs.
So this week on Stump Tom, Matt Phillips writes in, give us an email, and he's looking for a Bobby Kreiner song, something about being unhappy. And it took us some digging, Matt, but this is what we came up with. Bobby Kreiner, and I just can't stand to be unhappy.
I know it must be partly my fault. Somehow I guess I let you down. But the pure and simple truth is, honey, you've been running around. I always said that being honest is what this thing is all about. I always said the way I play this game is one strike and you're out. Ain't no point in being sorry, ain't no point in being nice, 'cause I ain't gonna hang around and let your lightning strike me twice. I just can't stand to be unhappy. You made this bed, you can lie in it, but you can't do it without me. I just can't stand to be unhappy. Honey, I just can't imagine whatever were you thinking of. You could be so rash and reckless as to gamble with our love. Love ain't worth a wooden nickel if you haven't got the trust. The brightest fire burns to ashes and the sweet dreams bite the dust. Ain't no point in being sorry, ain't no use in being nice, 'cause I ain't gonna hang around and let your lightning strike me twice. I just can't stand to be unhappy.
Bobby Kreiner, and I just can't stand to be unhappy, and you shouldn't have to be. Now, anybody that wants to play Stump Tom or send us a request or just let us know what's going on, just send an email to tomcole@tomcole.net. We'd love to hear from you. Well, we're going to take just a little bit of a break and hear from our sponsors. So hang tight. We're going to be right back with some more Vinyl Country. Vinyl Country's back, and here's something I bet you haven't heard for a while.
You were mine for just a while. Now you're putting on the style, and you've never once looked back at your home across the track. You're the gossip of the town, but my heart can still be found where you've tossed it on the ground. Pick me up on your way down. Pick me up on your way down. When you're blue and all alone, when the glamour starts to bore you, come on back where you belong. You may be their pride and joy, but they'll find another toy. Then they'll take away your crown. Pick me up on your way down. Way down, pick me up on your way down. When you're blue and all alone, when the glamour starts to bore you, come on back where you belong. You may be their pride and joy, but they'll find another toy. Then they'll take away your crown. Pick me up on your way down.
Webb Pierce, 1959, Pick Me Up on Your Way Down. Here at Vinyl Country, we like to collect old stories and old jokes, and then we like to retell them to you. So here's one that's older than dirt. There's a lady walking through the park when she inadvertently drops her false teeth in the tall grass. She's down on her hands and knees, frantically searching for her teeth, when a passerby sees her dilemma and steps in to give a hand. He finds out that it's her teeth that she's missing, and he says, "Here, I have a set in my pocket." She tries them on. She says, "These ones are much too big. They don't fit me." He said, "Well, here, try this set. I have another." She puts them in and says, "They're pretty small." He said, "Well, I just happen to have another set with me. Try these in." She puts them in and says, they really fit well. "Thank you very much." Said, "How fortunate I am to be way out here in the park and run into a dentist." To which the man replies, "I'm not a dentist. I'm an undertaker." Aww. You know, we didn't say they had to be good. They just have to be old.
This song's called The Midnight Choir at the Rescue Mission, corner of 4th and DeMundre, Nashville, Tennessee. How about a little steel guitar, Smith? The doors to the mission open at 7. and the soup will be ready about 9. Right now it's 6:30, they're ragged and dirty, they're standing and sitting and laying in line. First they'll do a little singing, then hear a little preaching, and get saved for the third time this week. A bowl of soup later and a pat on the shoulder, and by midnight they're back on the street. They walk to the corner of 4th Street and Broadway, then take the first alley on the right. One of them asks a stranger, how about hand? And he gives him one finger at a time. Then they spot an old buddy with a bottle of heaven, then pass around what means everything. One bottle for four, thank God someone scored, and now the midnight choir starts to sing.
Brothers with Mogan David. Coming up next, if you can remember back to 1987, this lady came here to Fort St. John and I got to introduce her on stage.
Ain't another love, just another love. I don't want to be just another love on your list of hearts. You've torn apart, then you cast them aside. All the young girls and making them down. You've given me an invitation to stay, but boy, you know my heart says I ought to be running away. Well, I've never been burned, so I guess it's my turn. I'm gonna see how strong I am. Ain't another love, just another love. I don't wanna be just another love. I don't wanna be
how strong I am. Another love, just another love. I don't wanna be just another love on your list of hearts. You've torn apart, then you cast them aside. Oh, can't you see that I don't wanna be? I don't wanna be just another love in your life. Well, I've never been hurt, so I'll see what it's worth. I'm gonna give your love a try.
Tanya Tucker, Just Another Love. Well, folks, that's it for another week. Thanks for dropping by. I do hope you get a chance to join me next week when we will spin some more great records from the past. We'll see you then. Bye-bye.
Final Country is recorded at Hilltop Studios. Producer and host is Tom Cole. Assistant producer is Margie Pugh. Source material is provided by the Bergen Sound Factory.